Hey guys, it is day 36 of Real Talk with Miranda, and it is December 2nd. Woo! Great. So first of all, before I get started into my final day of my totally 80s weekend, I want to show you a picture of me, my mom, my brother, our costumes matching up with, like, the people we're supposed to be. Because honestly, I really think we killed it. So, like, just please take a moment and bask in how awesome we are. Check it out. Have a moment. Like, I just think that we did such an awesome job of, like, anyway, just want to take a moment for that. I forgot to include that in yesterday's vlog. So anyway, let's wrap it up. I'm not gonna waste your all's time. I'm gonna get to the point here. So to finish up the 80s weekend, it is a top 10 list of my favorite, like, artists, musicians, bands of the 80s. And just, like, a little caveat, like, this is what I'm including. These bands can definitely have had made, like, music in the 70s and in the 90s and even now. Like, it's not like they were exclusively a band in the 80s. I'm personally looking at bands and musicians that, I don't know, like, had big hits in the 80s, were very popular, you know, just, they were big influences in, you know, the music industry in the 80s. So, like I said, they could have definitely made music in the 70s, and they definitely could have made music in the 90s, and now, and, you know, that's not, like, a big importance to me that it's, like, exclusively in the 80s. So there's that, and as always, there is no particular order in this list. So, let's get started with my top 10 list. Number one, this is gonna come to no surprise to anybody, of course, it's Madonna. As for Madonna, I really love her. She's known as the Queen of Pop, just so y'all know, and I agree with that sentiment for sure, because she's just so revolutionary. You know, she kind of came from this background of, like, she went to Catholic school, and I think her mother may have been really ill. She might have died, actually, to be completely honest. Don't quote me on that. I'm not 100% sure if that's true at all. I could just be making up crap. Anyway, she definitely has talked about, like, her sexual assaults before. Like, she kind of came from this, like, nobody lifestyle, and she had a rough time, kind of like an everyday lifestyle, and on top of that, kind of struggled with some problems that occurred in her life, which really stink. But she just was so ambitious, and I love that about her. Like, she, in an interview, someone said, like, what are your goals, or, like, what do you hope to you know, what do you hope to happen to you? And she's like, I hope to rule the world or something like that. And I just love that. Like, she was so ambitious. She didn't apologize for anything, and she just kind of went for it. And she took lots of risks, which could have been bad. And I think that, like, obviously they didn't turn out bad at all, but, like, not many people were wearing bras on the outside of their clothing back then. Like, now I feel like that wouldn't be unheard of, you know. Lady Gaga has worn some, like, very crazy outfits, as has, like, what Katy Perry has, I'm sure. You know, just, like, lots of people nowadays wear these very exotic and revealing clothing and costumes and create this interesting stage presence. And that was all Madonna, for sure. Like, she was definitely the first ones to dress so provocatively and wear very funky clothing. And, you know, she started out as a dancer. So, like, a lot of her, you know, songs come with these dances. Vogue, right? Like, it's a, you know, she kind of took to this, like, performing side of I don't know what I'm trying to say here. Yeah, but she, like, kind of created this, like, stage presence, which I think is, like, super cool, and I love it, and she didn't apologize for things. Like I said, she's super ambitious. Like, I mean, seriously, she wrote a coffee table book all about sex. Like, literally a coffee table book about sex. And it was, like, had very graphic pictures in it, and she, in definitely one of her videos, she, like, simulated, like, masturbation, orgasming, and, like, anyway, what I'm just trying to say is she took these risks and she, like, really made a name for herself, and I love it. And plus, her songs are just so catchy. Like, I was just thinking last night, like, what would be some, like, if I could pick 5 songs Madonna's, like, that would just be so hard. And I did it, but it was hard. Like, so Like a Prayer, Into the Groove, Papa Don't Preach, what else did I say? Vogue, and, Material Girl. The other two that I was, like, really struggling with, I wanted to add in Like a Virgin and Holiday, because those are fantastic songs. But, like I said, all of her music's really good. Although I will say that some of her newest stuff, I feel like she's trying to, like, get into, I don't know, what everyone else is trying to do now, and trying to remain hip and cool. And I just kind of like her, like, 80s roots. Like, I wish she would stay with that. But anyway, love Madonna, obviously. Super, super cool woman. All right, number 2, Queen. Queen, I think, is cool because they definitely had, like, a big presence in the 70s as well. And then, like, their stuff really came out in the 80s too. So, like, they had a good presence, like, in both decades. Obviously, the greatest rock song of all is Bohemian Rhapsody. Fantastic song. And I just, like, that's definitely a song that my brother and me and our friends Martin and Jack will definitely just, like, come together and really sing it out loud, and it's great. But some of my favorite Queen songs would definitely be Fat Bottom Girls. I love that one so much. I love Under Pressure, that song that they sang with David Bowie. Of course, a little fun fact, if you didn't know, You're My Best Friend, that song, was written by the bassist John Deacon, and he wrote it for his wife, and they've been together since the 70s, and they're still together now, and I just think that's really sweet and very cute. So next time you hear that song, it's about his wife. You're My Best Friend. So, very sweet song. And I love that, like, every single one of their songs is just, like, such an amazing hit. Like, we were in the car, we were singing, like, Radio Gaga, we were just, like, talking about how, like, all of their music is just so freaking good. And I love that all 4 of the members of the band were so heavily involved in the making of the band and the making of the songs and the writing. Like, they've all been inducted, I think, into some Rock and Roll Hall of Fame of, like, for their songwriting. Like, each one of them wrote songs and won awards for it. Like, they were all extremely talented, and I liked how they came together as a group, of course. And I also really like, I really like their collaboration. I also really like their camaraderie, I guess you could say, their family dynamic. Like, they definitely took care of one another. And I've definitely seen when, you know, Freddie Mercury was, you know, kind of figuring out who he was sexually, and then, you know, got the diagnosis of, you know, having AIDS, and they definitely stood by him through thick and thin. And, you know, I think that that's just really powerful, very, very much so. Plus, they put on some of the most amazing shows and had great stage presence as well. Like, their Live Aid show had, I don't even know how many viewers and participants in that concert, but it was fantastic. You should watch it on YouTube. It's amazing. It's really, really good. So, Queen is definitely on the list. Okay, number 3, Prince. I love Prince, and I was so bummed when he died. Like, was that 2016? It was a couple years ago, I think, but it was recently. I really like Prince. I also think that he had a really good stage presence. I love his costumes. Very dramatic. And I think that's one of the best things about most of these 80s bands is they're just flamboyancy, they're the drama behind it, the costumes, the stage presence. It's plus they're on top of all that, the music is really good. Like I think nowadays, like we sometimes sacrifice like how good the music is and can be in order to have like this dramatic stage presence and fun features that happen with the cost like the concert. And like they, I feel like they had both. Like they were definitely really good music and musicians. There was really good music, but at the same time they were able to like make it super entertaining and fun. I like that, and I think Prince really did encompass that. And I think all his music is just such a it's similar but different. I don't know if I can describe it any better, but yeah, I like how he definitely had like persona through his music, and at the same time, every song didn't sound like exactly the same. It was similar but different. That's like all I can say. So I think some of my favorite songs from Prince would definitely be Seven, Doves Cry, Let's Go Crazy is definitely probably my favorite. The Never Take Your Place of Your Man, that's a good song. Once again, it's too hard to just narrow it down because there's just so many fantastic songs. Oh, Alphabet Street, I love that one. Anyway, fantastic artist. He's amazing. Okay, number four, Cyndi Lauper. Also, kind of like Madonna in the sense that she was risky. She definitely took risks, maybe not as much as Madonna did with like, simulating masturbation and stuff like that in music videos and on stage. But Cyndi Lauper, her vocal range is amazing. Like, wow, she can really hit some low notes. She can really hit some high notes. I love her vocal range. And her songs, I feel like, have a lot of passion and feeling behind them, and they're also like really good to dance to. So like Time After Time or True Colors, like those are just like beautiful songs. But then like Girls Just Want to Have Fun, or like I love that she wrote the theme song for The Goonies. Like those are like some maybe like more fun, dancier songs. I don't know. She's great. She's a super cool person. Plus, and I went as her for Halloween when I was 13, and I wore the same costume that I wore last night as Madonna. I did a little bit of different stuff with my hair and my makeup and things like that, because like Cyndi Lauper had like a shaved head on the side, like all the hair on the side, which is like funny because that's now like kind of like a style now. So anyway, I really love, like, Cyndi Lauper has been like a really big voice in the LGBTQ community as well. I think she had a child who's in that community, and she's definitely been vocal about that and working towards, equal rights, and I really love her humanitarian work just as much as I like her singing. So, definitely love Cyndi Lauper. Okay, number five, The Cure. The Cure is, there's two people on this list that I have had the, pri well, actually, there are three people on this list I've had the privilege of seeing live. I got to see them front row. They played for like 4 hours. They did like four encores, I swear. And I love how much energy they still have, and I love like their youthfulness. They're still like Robert Smith, the guy that my mom dressed up as, still definitely had his hair all like frizzy and big, and he still wore heavy eyeliner. He danced so much, and he sang so soulfully, and like all dressed in black. And I just love the youthfulness and like the passion towards their music. Like, they're not giving up. Like, they are still touring, they're still rocking, and I love that. And this band also has like some nostalgic pieces as well. The song Close to Me, it I have definitely seen lots of home videos with my dad holding me as like a couple weeks old, and like we're dancing together to that song. And so it was super cool to get to go to the concert together and like listen to that song when I was 18. Like, this is like 18 years later after that video was taken, but like super cool. And I would totally include it if I could, but it's on a VHS tape, so it's not really feasible. So anyway, but I love The Cure, and they've got like, again, so many hits. Like I said, Close to Me is one of my favorites. Pictures of You is really good. My dad listened to that one a lot after my grandma died, so I definitely like have some sentimental value to that. It definitely reminds me of my grandma. And Six Different Ways is one of my favorite songs as well. And Just Like Heaven. And Boys Don't Cry. And like, right, there's so many. Like, and that just goes for all these groups, is that like, it's hard to narrow it down to how many to your favorite songs, because they're just all fantastic. Okay, number 6. Pat Benatar. Another person I was lucky enough to go and see. She came to Fort Collins, I don't know, 4 years ago? 5 years ago? And I got to go and see her. And it was a fantastic show, and she actually plays with her husband. Like, he does the guitars, I think, for her, or some instrument, I don't remember, but they play together, and I think that's super cool. I like Pat Benatar's variety, I guess you could say. Like, listening to what's that song called? Heartbreaker. Yeah, Heartbreaker is definitely a rock song, and that's in the 70s, so it's not an 80s song, but like, Heartbreaker is such a good song. But then you like, and it's definitely like a rock song, for sure, but then you kind of like come over here and you look at like, We Belong, it's so different. We Belong is more like this like ballad, and it seems like We Belong, right? Like, it's like so different, but I love it. I love her versatility. So, yeah, and I really like, what other ones do I really like? Shadows in the Night, Hit Me With Your Best Shot, of course, it's really good. Love is a Battlefield. Yeah. There's a lot. It's hard to, like, once again, hard to narrow it down. There's that. I love Pat Benatar. Number 7, Michael Jackson. Don't think you can talk about the 80s without talking about Michael Jackson. once again, so many hits. I was really into Michael Jackson when I was like 10 years old. And then he died the day after my 11th birthday. And it was very sad for me, because I was like, it was the start of my obsession with the 80s. And so like, Michael Jackson was one of my favorites, as was Madonna. And he's the king of pop, she's the queen of pop, right? Like, they were definitely revolutionary in kind of the pop field, which I don't think the pop field has kind of gone down, unfortunately. Like, they were great, they were too great. And then it's just not as good anymore. But yeah, like, I don't know. I was just so upset. I definitely did dance the Thriller at my prom, and everyone watched. Like, me and a couple of my friends knew the Thriller, and so we danced it. I dance every Halloween. I love the Thriller. It's so much fun. Cool video. I like love the idea that like Michael Jackson's just like randomly, because like, this is on like a regular album. This is not on like a Halloween themed album. He just like, I guess I'm gonna write a Halloween song. I love it. I'm like, if I was talented enough to like write music, I would just randomly write a Halloween song, because Halloween is life. So I just think that that's super fun. And I love Billie Jean. I love Smooth Criminal. Of course, it's fun to hear him in the Jackson 5 as well. So anyway, fantastic. Fantastic artist. And I think, once again, revolutionary with that stage presence. Like, he has some pretty famous dance moves, of course, and definitely like wanted to, you know, dress up in costumes and things like that. So, pretty fun, pretty cool things. Okay, number 8. Definitely can't talk about the 80s without talking about David Bowie. Love David Bowie, he's amazing. And a lot of his work, like, my favorite song ever, honestly, a tie for my all-time favorite songs ever is Like a Prayer by Madonna and Heroes by David Bowie. And Heroes actually came out in the 70s, came out in 79, but I love it. It reminds me of, like, I don't know, it gives me a nostalgic feeling, even though I was not alive in the 70s, but, like, it just did. It just does. Like, I don't know, like, listening to it makes me happy, it reminds me of childhood, reminds me of, like, being with friends, and it also gives me, like, this hope for the future. So when a song can make you feel something like that, like, I think it's really powerful, and that's definitely what David Bowie's song Heroes does for me. And he obviously has fantastic songs elsewhere as well, like, other than that, like, Modern Love, Let's Dance, Changes, of course they quote that one in the Breakfast Club, so that's great. What else? Rabble Rabble, like, it's just so many, so many. And I think he also did some good stuff for the LGBTQ community, arguably. I've heard other sources say no, kind of depends on how you look at things, but anyway, and of course David Bowie with Queen was just like fantastic. I love Under Pressure so much, and then they had to go and ruin it with that stupid Ice Ice Baby song, but it's still good. Okay, I'm moving right along. Number 9, Beastie Boys, of course, and they started out in the 80s. They also had a lot of hits in the 90s as well. But I love listening to the Beastie Boys because, like, you hear, it just feels so raw and authentic. Like, I feel like listening to them sounds like you really are just, like, listening into, like, a garage band, you know, recording session with these three high school dudes that are really good friends. And that's how it started. Like, these guys, like, were all really good friends in high school, and they're like, we should start a band, and they, like, kind of got together in their garage and started rapping. And but also, like, I love them again because the versatility is so cool. Like, they got good rap songs, they got, like, some rock songs, they got some, like, you know, electronic stuff going on with, like, Intergalactic. And so I like how they weren't, like, really afraid to experiment and to try. Like, it's super cool. But yeah, I love just, like, you listen to it and you're like, you feel kind of like a part of it. Like, it feels so raw and you're like, yeah, like, just messing around and, like, it's super fun. And you can hear that, like, friendship even when they're just singing. I don't know, like, I feel like I can just hear their friendship. And that was also tragic when one of them died. I don't know, I think that was about 5 years ago. And so I definitely remember that, because I got off the bus and this kid that was on the bus too was wearing a Beastie Boys shirt, and I was like, sad day, man. And he was like, yeah, I know. And, like, that was the only time we talked, but I feel like we connected over the Beastie Boys. And they recently released a book. I watched them on Jimmy Fallon, the two remaining guys, Ad Rock and Mike D, I think. And they're super feminists, which I love. Like, one of them's married to one of the lead singers in Pussy Riot, which is a super cool girl punk rock band. And I think that that's super cool. And they, like, actually came out and apologized. So, like, sorry, like, some of our vocals when we were young and dumb and not self-aware yet was just like, he's like, I think that they were sexist and I'm sorry for that. I'm like, that is so cool that, like, people, like, can come forward and say something like that. So definitely gotta love the Beastie Boys. Plus, once again, Garrick, Mara, and Jack and I can crush Fight for Your Right. Just, we crush it. They've got great songs. Fight for Your Right is one of my favorites, as is Hey Ladies. My dad used to sing that one with us all the time when we were like 2 or 3. Like, we would dance to Hey Ladies all the time. And then what would we? I love Brass Monkey, of course, and What You Want is probably one of my favorites too. So many. And lastly, number 10, another band that I have been privileged enough to come and see in Fort Collins just a few months ago, the Psychedelic Furs. They're fantastic, and I love their song Pretty in Pink for the movie Pretty in Pink. And so when they played that one at the encore, like, I was recording it, and I just went, just screaming. It's such an obnoxious video. I think I deleted it, because I was like, that's just annoying, but I was just so excited, and it was front row, and they were, like, I could reach out and touch them. Like, and they were, like, singing into my eyes. I feel like we had a connection. It was amazing. And once again, like, older people, like, getting out there and still, like, doing their thing and still rocking and still, like, appreciating their art. I love it. It makes me so happy. So that was really a privilege to get to see them just a couple months ago. Yeah, and they've got great stuff. Once again, I think their song Ghost in You, I think that's the one. Ghost in You. I definitely have also found home videos on VHS tapes of me dancing to that when I was like 3 years old. So once again, what a privilege to get to go like and actually see them. Because my love for the 80s, man. My parents created that. They're the one who introduced me with like all this like 80s music and movies and stuff. And now look at me. I'm obsessed. So love them. Love Psychedelic Furs. And I will throw in one last little one. Like, I'm not going to include the entire band, but this is an honorable mention because one of my all-time favorite 80s songs is Pour Some Sugar on Me by Def Leppard. And I love it so much. And so it has to be the honorable mention here is that song. And I really don't know any other Def Leppard song. Maybe a couple others, but it felt needed a little bit just to like include the fact that I love that song and Def Leppard really, really crushed it. So that's it. Oh my goodness. Yay. Totally 80s weekend is in the books. I had a lot of fun with talking about these top 10 lists and getting to dress up yesterday. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed as well. And we'll be back. I'll be back 80s again. I'll be back tomorrow.